Hello guys, welcome back to the new episode of Road to CMake. In this episode, we will be learning about install command in CMake. So the install command is used to install your build targets to the specified location, or this command can also be used to package your project for distribution, or we can simply say that to install the build targets to your local system. Let's see the documentation of the install command on the CMake website. When you will open a CMake install documentation, you can find a lot of information which can be confusing if somebody is a beginner for a CMake. So let's don't read directly from the documentation. I will directly explain you how to use an install command using a CMake list, and I will tell you what's the syntax of using a CMake install command. So let's directly jump into the Visual Studio Editor and creating a simple CMake project and see how the install function or command works using a CMake list.txt. Let's open a Visual Studio 2022 Community Edition, which I'm using. So let's create a new project, a CMake project. Let's select from the recent project template, and when you click a CMake project and then press next, you can name it, let's say, install function CMake, and then let's press create, and the Visual Studio will set up a simple CMake project for you. After Visual Studio has been set up a CMake project, now we can just click on the Solution Explorer, and then we can see there is a folder install function CMake, in which it contains a CMake list.txt, which contains a add executable function. And let's say if CMake version greater than 3.12, let's not use it at the moment. It will make you confused. And let's remove it for a while. And then we can see install function CMake.cpp, and which contains a simple cout code for hello CMake. And then there is a header file which just contain include IO stream. No headers are there at the moment. And then there is a base, or we can say a root CMake list, which include the subdirectory which contain our CPP and a header file. And this defines the CMake minimum required and a project name. And then there is an out folder which contains a build folder. In this build folder, when you build the project, your executable will be placed in this folder. Let's press the build option using this build and then press build all. As you can see, it will build an executable for our CMake project. When we press on this Solution Explorer, we can see any executable in this build folder because it's not reflecting somehow. Let's open folder in a file explorer. As we can see, there is a folder named CX64 debug, and then in that folder, if you go install function CMake, you can see there is an application which has been built and placed there. So directly see that your code has been built. Let's choose directly from the play button and let's run this code. And when we run the code, it will show a hello CMake. As we can see that when we build the project, it placed a executable file in the default path. Let's say we want to place our executable path in some specified directory. So for that, we can use an install command. Like when you build the project and then you want to, instead of doing that manually, you can just use an install command in CMake list to copy that executable into the specified folder in which you want to copy it. So let's go into the CMake list. After the add executable, we will be adding install. And then in this function, it requires the target. So you can write our targets. And then you need to pass the name of your executable. So our executable name is install function CMake. And now you need to specify the directory. So there are multiple components. Components is the type of your target you want to install in the in that destination. So for executable type, this is a runtime component, and then you can pass a destination argument, and then we can pass the path of our destination where we want to install, or we can say the install or copy our executable file. So let's use a CMake source directory, and let's say slash bin, and when you press enter slash bin, it will create a new folder for you. Now when you save this executable with this cmakelist.txt, it will generate the project again. Now let's see in this build option. Now you can see there is an install function cmake option is also showing. So let's press this install function. As you can see that installing function, when you press the install function, it's showing that it copy in the desktop install function CMake, and it creates a bin folder and copied our executable file in that specified directory which we have passed here. So the source CMake source directory is the source directory of the project, and you can see if there is a bin folder and where the executable file has been copied just using a simple install command. So what about the other types of targets? For example, libraries, static or shared, or we can say the header files or some XYZ files, let's say license file or other files. We want to install, or we can say copy those files to the specific directory using the install command. Because when we package the project, it contains a lot of things. For example, a libraries, a header files, and XYZ other stuff. So let's see how we can use the other targets, or we can say install the other targets using install command. So now let's take a look how to install the other types of files. So let's start with the library. So to create the library, we need to add a function name as void library, and then we need to define this function, let's say void library, and let's say std, let's use cout because we are using std as well. So cout, and let's say hello CMake library, and we have used an l. So now when we have defined our function, now we need to edit our CMake list. So let's say we need to create a library, a static library first. For that, we will be calling a function add library. Let's copy it all because we are using the same files. Change the target name. And for the static library or for .lib file, we need to add static component. And now we need to edit our install function to install our static library to a specific folder. For that, the component we are using, first we need to define a target. We can say add a target here. So the target name is install function cmakelib. We will copy it and then just paste it. And then after that, we need to define a component, that what component or what type of file we are installing. So for the libraries file, for the static library file, the component name is archive, and let's set a destination, and we will be creating a new folder, let's say in a source directory, the lib folder. So now let's save it. It will generate the project again, and then when we press install function cmake, it will install. So now we can see that our .lib file is installed in a source folder, and it creates a folder lib and install function cmake lib.lib. For the shared libraries, now we need to add a library function again. Let's say call the library function again. Now we just need to edit our component, which is shared, which creates a DLL file. And let's change the name to DLL. And when we save it, it generates a project again. And for the install function, we don't need to edit anything, because in Windows, the runtime means .executables and for DLL files. But if we are using a Linux, then we need to specify a component to install our DLL file .so file, because in a Linux, the shared libraries are .so files. So for the .so files, we need to add the component, which is library, and the same as we need to set the destination, which will install the .so file to the specific directory. And in Windows, the runtime is used for both DLL and executable files. So what about the other files? For example, the header files or the CPP files we want to export, or we can say we want to ship with our project. So we want to install our header files to a specific folder. For that, we will be using the same install function. Let's say install. But instead of targets, now we will use a files, and then the same as you need to specify the file, what file we need to install to the specific folder. So let's say we will be using a header file of our project. Let's say CMake source dir, and let's say the folder name is install function, and let's say a header file. Now, same as the for the libraries and the executable, we've set the destination. Here we also set the destination. So let's use and let's say the folder name as header. So when we save it, so now the project has been generated, and when we click on the install, then we can see that it installed our header file to a specific folder named header, and we can see that there is a header folder has been created. When we can say click on that, we can see that our header file has been installed to that specific directory. This is how we can use an install function, or we can say install command in CMake. So I hope you guys have learned a lot about a CMake install command. So this is a kickstart. We can say there are a lot more options used in an install function. You can explore using a CMake documentation. And I have just given you a kickstart and a basic information, or we can say a basic know-how how to start using an install function in CMake. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video. Thank you guys for watching.